First of all, I would like to say that similar to Andrei, I change the subject of my talk because the first reason is absolutely the same like Andrei Zaikin, I mean, said that it was my old title was submitted 3 years ago. This is already old, life is going on. But there is a second reason as well to change it, because look into the program of the session, I found following, that first talk was about disordered superconducting thin films. And this is also my subject, simply another material. Instead of molybdenum C, I will consider niobium nitride. Second talk by Andrei Semyonov was about quantum phase sleeps. And I will touch this problem in my talk. And third, Andrei Zaikin, our chairman, told about some ideas of Shapiro steps, how to explain it. I also will talk about Shapiro steps. So I mean that my talk is really very nicely contributed to the subject of the whole session. So note that this work was done in collaboration between Leibniz Institute of Photonic Technology, Jena, where I am, Royal Holloway, and you see people, this is a group of Oleg Astafyev here, and Chalmers University of Technology, where the Professor Kubatkin is leader of group. So the online of talk is following. So first of all, niobium nitrate film is in principle very attractive subject to investigate, and of course it's due to single photon detectors, which is widely used now for quantum communication, especially bolometers, maybe, you know, activity of Grigory Goltzman and other guys from Karlsruhe as well. I will not touch this problem. I simply say that, in principle, niobium nitride film is well known, in principle, in superconducting community. And they are known because they have a very large kinetic inductance, especially thin film. And in principle, it's possible to make some kind of parametric amplifiers, which is of interest, because parametric amplifier, traveling wave parametric amplifier, required many Josephson junctions in order to make nonlinear system. But maybe by making new kinetic inductance technology can be simplified. This I will show you our first experimental result. And of course, quantum phase sleep, and this is basically very attractive basic science, how one can realize such junction, and I will show you what's going on in this direction. And what is our achievement in that sense? So we simply develop novel type of technology for fabrication niobium nitride film called atomic layer deposition. And let me start. First of all, I would shortly characterize our technology. I mean results. I don't want to go into detail because I have only 20 minutes for my talk. So no sense to go deeply to technology because everything is published. You can find here detail of technology. But first of all, this deposition type, you can make an huge size of substrate. Here you see 4-inch substrate, more or less homogeneous field. I will show you just several slides below that it's very important for instance, for application, for making parametric amplifiers. And you see this is somehow it's homogeneous in order of the inch. So this is critical temperature, if you will follow this line, yeah, critical temperature, width of superconducting transition, resistance, critical current, whatever, it's everything characterized, even X-ray detection. So, and by the way, this film is also only 6 nanometers. This is relatively very thin. And if you see this resistance, so we already have reasonable doubt because resistance is here, is above 250 ohm per square. So this is really high enough. And then secondly, what is very interesting for this film, these films exhibit so-called superconductor isolated transition as a function of thickness. So this is our results on the left-hand side of slide. So we make different thickness of the film. By the way, atomic layer deposition is characterized a well-controlled thickness of the obtained film. This is because this is some kind cycle deposition. And while cycle, it corresponds to 0.5 angstrom. So you can control thickness of your film really precise. And you see that starting with around 30 nanometers, we have a reasonable field with temperature close to 15K critical temperature. And then decreasing of thickness, we reproducibly get transition between superconducting and isolated state. And this was made something like these resistive measurements with a bridge with 300 micrometers length and 5 micrometers width of such kind of thing. And this result is published already 4 years ago. And then we, for future application, for trying to fabricate quantum phase sleep, we developed some kind of lithography. Mainly, this lithography is used in Royal Holloway, but we also have it. And you see, we can fabricate reproducible constriction of widths of 20 nanometers. This width of all this nanowire is around 100 nanometers. So, and let me tell several words about parametric amplifier. This was developed in Chalmers University of Technology. Design concept is very, very long line, which fabricated on the sapphire substrate. The width of the line 0.5 meters and total length about 5 meters, you see. And this is technological achievement. So you can make very long line on the 3-inch wafer substrate with such kind of length without interruption, without breaking the contact. And first results, you can see here, first of all, how we fabricated, it was fabricated on Chalmers. You see this line, this is some kind of segment, and this is segments is, you see some 1,200 signal fractional units here. And this film was 50 nanometers thickness. And first result is shown here. We really fabricate wideband parametric amplifier with amplification of about 10 dB in best case, but it's difficult to avoid the oscillation of gain. And this is because strongly nonlinear system, as soon as power is slightly changed of frequency, so the phase condition is changed and you really see such kind of oscillation of gain, which in principle our task for future to fight with. Yeah, so this is first experimental result, not published. And let me go to quantum phase sleep idea, which work was made together with Royal Holloway, and measurements was done in Royal Holloway University. Basically, introduction for this subject has been already done by Andrei Semyonov. Nevertheless, I should mention this first work of our chairman here, who proposed such kind of effect in weakling. And to comment slightly, I will simply refer to this paper of Hans Moy and Yuli Nazarov, which really, apart from complicated Hamiltonians here, make it very simple. And Andrei Semyonov also told about duality, but this is really important for experimentalists, because if you consider Josephson junction, your main effect here is tunneling of Cooper pair. And here, phase sleep junction, you have current in Cooper pair, and your effect is tunneling flux across the junction. And taking this into account, you can really see, okay, this is a real duality between these two junctions. Andrei told about this, but in principle, what you can write down, you can, because for conventional Josephson junction, you can write so-called RSG model. And you can, by making use duality, rewrite RSG model for phase sleep junction. And this is shown here. Instead of phase of flux, you will see charge and that's all. So you can really complete duality. But then, very important, what Andrei Zaikin told today, voltage step, Shapiro step. for conventional Josephson junction, you have voltage steps. By making use duality for phase-lit junction, you should have current steps. And of course, you can get it from this model both. You can simply calculate it with this simplified model, not making use Hamiltonians or whatever. And this is immediate question arise. If you have current steps, it's really important for metrology, because you know voltage standard is really well accepted standard in metrology, Josephson voltage standard. But in this case, if you can have such kind of dual steps, maybe you can realize current standard. And this problem was understood 25 years ago, whatever. And it was, and first attack was by making use conventional tunnel junction. But let me say following, if you have conventional tunnel junction, it's difficult to talk about this junction in sense of duality, because for conventional junction, Josephson coupling energy much larger than charge energy. And if you would like to have duality, charge energy should be much larger than Josephson coupling energy. But in this case, you have Coulomb blockade and you don't have any current. So how you can come up with these conclusions, with these constraints? Nevertheless, it was work was done by Dima Averin, Sasha Zorin, and Konstantin Likarev long ago, when they say, okay, let us consider Josephson junction where charge energy is not negligible. And you should put the Hamiltonian this charge, and this is because you have small capacity in Josephson junction. And in principle, if you will go through this paper and follow this calculation, which is, by the way, not so difficult even for me, yeah, you can get that you should have some kind of current steps. But in this case, optimum is here, because you should have some kind of transport in your current transport, in your Josephson junction. And after that, there were a number of experimental work, and I would like to refer to well-known work of Leonid Kuzmin and David Haviland. It was published in 1999, where some features of these steps was observed. But only features, and of course, it's very difficult to say anything about application, to use it somehow. Only idea of this paper is okay, such kind of, that, by the way, because it's Hamiltonian, it's very similar to Hamiltonian of a single particle in periodic potential, such kind of, and this is some kind of Bloch signs, this oscillation called Bloch oscillation. This is just terminology, but doesn't matter. It's some kind of current Shapiro steps, I would like to say. So, and it was difficult to get really visible, very visible steps similar to Shapiro steps of conventional Josephson junction. And what we see, we are a part of conventional tunnel junction. We go just to nanowire, and this is our chip, which was fabricated with our film in Royal Holloway. And you see how it's protected. So first of all, it's 4-point measurements. Here resistance, this is gold palladium of about 20 kilo-ohm. This is some kind of inductor fabricated from niobium nitride, also for frequency of 10 gigahertz is also the resistance of 20 kilo-ohm. This is 4-point measurements, 4-point contact measurement. This is microwave line with some capacitance and some kind of resistance here and inductance here. And here is our nanowire. Nanowire is 100 nanometers width with constriction here of about 20 nanometers. And point is that thickness of this film is very close to superconductor insulator transition. So thickness of our film is about 3 nanometers. And resistance, square resistance, if you're interested in this, is something like 4 kilo-ohm per square. And unbelievable, what we get is this is voltage current characteristic. For me, it's really very, very unusual, because you see voltage current characteristics in big scale, you see critical current of our nanowire. This is something like 100 nanometers. This is critical current. And you have some small hysteretic here, of course, due to heating, because if you go here, you go to, you jump to resistive K, and if you go back because of overheating, this critical current is slightly smaller. That's clear, okay. But if you make zoom here, unbelievable, you see Coulomb blockade. And this is Coulomb blockade of about of 2 microvolts only. So, and this, I must say that immediately after this voltage current characteristic, I would like to say, it should be current Shapiro step. And indeed we observe it, and you see it's very well visible without any derivative. We measure it in voltage current characteristic. And this Shapiro steps is shown here. This is external frequency of 14 gigahertz. This is 25 gigahertz. We observe it up to 30 gigahertz, and our best Shapiro step corresponds to 10 nanoampere of current. I must say this is not only one sample. This we made something like 10 samples that is really reproducible. For all samples, we see some features with different, of course, with different with different widths of Shapiro steps, with different of Coulomb blockade. It's maybe several microvolt, even larger. But for all samples, we observe this feature. For all samples, it's really very nice. So I mean that niobium nitrides is very interesting materials where it can be observed. And last figure I would like to show, this is for metrology. It's really our current dependent on frequency. You see straight line and you will fit it, you will get charge of Cooper pair. And our last point is 10 nanoamp. And I must say following, in metrology, for voltage standard, now the best current we achieved is something like 160-170 picoamp. And the people use for that some kind of quantum dots. And these quantum dots, it's if you increase frequency, because for metrology you should use equation that current is proportional to charge multiplied to frequency. And if you for quantum dot increase frequency, you get non-adiabatic, you get transition to other levels, and you could not increase frequency. Our sample is working up to 30 gigahertz. And point is that restriction is not technical. Let me remind you that standard voltage standard for conventional Josephson junction is working at 70 gigahertz. So I believe that we can also increase our frequency, but for current experiment, we could not do it because this is restriction of cables. We simply could not put to our dilution fridge such high frequency. This work somehow in progress. And my last conclusion, this is our future activity. About parametric amplifier, of course, we should have better matching between input signal and parametric amplifier, because due to huge kinetic inductance, you have mismatch, of course, and this should be somehow, we have some ideas how to improve it, and we believe that we can make wideband a parametric amplifier in close future. And, of course, this oscillation. By the way, it's not only for our parametric amplifier, it's even some kind of slant, gain ripple, they call it. And this should be somehow avoided in order to make amplifier really attractive for application. For quantum phase sleep, we're still thinking about role of environment for our Coupe-S weakling, because we did it somehow without any deep thinking. We simply would like to say, okay, we would like to protect our very sensitive quantum junction against external environment, aggressive external environment. But we did not analyze it in detail. Now we are doing this. And of course, we have some kind of final slope of current steps, which is not good for metrology, and we would like to understand reasons. Of course, it should be some kind of noise, but how to protect it, this is also our task, and now we are thinking about it. I must say that both these results are still not published because this is still in progress, but on the other hand, I believe that this is really very nice result, especially about quantum phase sleep junction. So thank you for your attention.
Женя, so I did not quite get why is your system, which is of course very nice and interesting and promising, why is it better than just well-controlled tunnel junctions in the sense you are talking about?
Okay, following calculation, as I know, you can get current Shapiro steps, right? But point, maybe I will show next. Okay, my intuitive, I will show you the next slide. It's exactly about this. Look, this is, I did try to compare tunnel junction and nanowire junction. In tunnel junction, if EG is equal to EC, you have strongly hysteretic behavior of voltage current characteristics. This simply means that EG is characteristic energy, and if you apply RF power, it can be some kind of Zener transition from this branch to resistive branch, because protection is only Josephson coupling energy, which is not so high. But if you produce with RF power such kind of transition, you will kill your Shapiro state. You will wash it out. But for nanowire, you have another voltage current characteristic. You have small hysteretic due to overheating, but here you don't have upper band, you have just normal state, and your characteristic energy is delta. And to my understanding, such kind of junction much better protected against external noise, external power, than tunnel junction. This is my suggestion.
Okay, perhaps we should discuss it maybe.
We can discuss it
some other time, but I just want to say that this hysteretic behavior, it depends very much on the external environment also. So you can, in fact, I think, control it too, because your system is in some sense is not so much different from tunnel junction. Of course, it's not tunnel junction, but it's a kind of weak link also. And you can gradually move from tunnel junction by increasing transmission and so on to your system.
But that's definitely correct. But if you include transition, you will not get tunnel conductivity. That's the point. If you will go from tunnel junction to nanowire, you will improve it, to my intuitive suggestion, in order to get dual Shapiro state. Mm-hmm. That's my point. Mm-hmm. You should use a high transparency junction, not tunnel junction.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, maybe that's okay. So let's maybe talk some other time.
In derivation of equation for quasi particles in small Josephson junctions, Likarev Averin approach used high impedance environment for Josephson junction, and here Yevgeny Ilyich says that now is. We should discuss, maybe investigate in future moments related with impedance of and influence of impedance to such systems. Here, I would like to ask origin of this approach. This one related with the case of Josephson junction with quantum phase slipping or normal Josephson junction.
So, as I do understand, following, of course, in original work of Averin, Zorin, and Likarev, a high impedance environment is described. I agree. Moreover, experimentally, Kuzmin and Haviland and all other guys, they use high impedance environment in order to try to measure such kind of Shapiro steps. But then question was, why we don't observe it experimentally? And answer of in one paper of Sasha Zorin was, due to high impedance of environment, we unavoidably have close to our Josephson junction quasi-particles. And these quasi-particles kills our coherent behavior, kill our Shapiro steps. But we could not avoid this, because we need to have this high impedance environment. And my point is, and our point, not my, I mean, we do it very close together with Oleg Astafiev. This activity in quantum phase sleep, we are doing definitely together, and Oleg is really moving power, I mean, Oleg Astafiev. So, point is, maybe we can substitute of high impedance environment by huge inductors. And this is on chip, we use both. We use inductance and resistance, if you remember, in our chip. And now question is it possible simply to use inductance? Or, I mean, how to make optimum in order to fabricate junction with a zero slope somehow, in order to use it for metrology? That's my answer. So not question is not to use environment, but point how to optimize this environment, because we have inductance and we have resistance. How to optimize it? It should be somehow moderate and calculated. So that's my answer.